You take the blue pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
800
beer are kind
of dead. Personally,
it's the Axetruth Show, cutting through the bullshit.
What's up, everyone? Axel here of Axetruth.com, and this is where I cut through the bullshit. All video, sound, and music used during this broadcast falls under fair use. Fair use is allowed for the purpose of criticism, news reporting, teaching, and parody, which doesn't infringe on copyright under 17 USC 107. Sorry, you guys, about last night's live stream. We had some technical problems. Fuyu was not able, didn't set up my chat board, so I wasn't able to do it. But I am doing it tonight at 8 p.m. Tacky Tuesdays. I shall not be moved. The mashup. So join me later for that. But right now, we're going to cut through this bullshit right here. We have the audacity of the migrants. Illegal immigrants, what is the name? Undocumented workers. They're just coming here for a better life. you know, they are migrants. They're immigrants. No, they're not immigrants. You can't illegally come here. They broke into our country, and now they're demanding housing. They're refusing to leave out of the New York hotels, and they're demanding housing. So without any further ado, let's roll the tape here.
The Watson Hotel on West 57th Street in Manhattan has been housing migrants. They've been here for a while. They have roots here. They have jobs here. They're part of this community. And now they're being told they have to get on a New York City bus and go to Red Hook to a cruise terminal that's got about 1,000 beds, cots, I think 3 or 4 bathrooms, and no place for them to put their stuff.
Stories. We need one thing to be clear. Eric Adam only has one plan so far. Eric Adam's plan is to loot the city's departments and give that money to the NYPD and the developers who are gentrifying this city. He could have easily, along with Governor Hochul, opened up all the vacant luxury apartments. We are on 57th Street right now. This is Billionaire's Row. Half of the super towers on this street are empty. These are $40 million apartments.
You hear that? Did you hear that? I know, did you hear that? The audacity. He said, this is Billionaire Row. $40 million apartments, half of them are empty, so put the migrants in it. Put them in there. In $40 million apartments, because they need a place to stay. You got that? I hope y'all listening to this. Well, see, just, I want you to take that in for a minute. I want every American, especially you shines, especially you shines, because y'all the ones over there with them Democrats. Y'all the ones over there hugging and scrawling and cracking and licking out the Democrat ass. Telling them to bring these migrants in, these illegals in. I'm saying it just like it is. They're bringing them in here and they're giving them a place to stay while there are millions of Americans getting evicted and foreclosed on and being getting evicted and being foreclosed on and going to be homeless. They can't demand housing. They're not going to be put up in a hotel. They're not going to be placed in million-dollar apartments. The audacity of these people that think they can come over here and even to protest, resist leaving the hotel that was given to them. But you sambos and mammies, y'all want them in. Bring all of them in, more brown people, because the white folks are upset, right? They the ones mad. They being racist. This is absolutely, I'm so sickened by this, because he said there are $40 million apartments that are vacant. Put them in it. They don't want to go to the little tent city, this big tent area or building they got set up with a bunch of cots for these grown men to sleep on a cot. They giving them free food. They're giving them shelter. That ain't enough. Remember I reported last week how they throwing away the food that it was given because they don't like it. It's not their cuisine. They don't like it. Just the thought of this. Every time I think about this, I think about my mother having that sign in her yard saying, nobody's illegal. And I looked at that sign. I'm sitting up here going like, she don't even believe it. See, that's what's wrong with you NPC Democrats over there. You swallow up and go with everything they put on your plate. Even when you know it's a bunch of certified bullshit. I mean, the fact that these people think they are going to, they're refusing to stay, to leave the hotel. Let me give you another clip here.
Here in the Watson Hotel with migrants who are being forced out of their shelters.
Asylum seekers and activists spilling onto the street in Midtown as they protested the relocation of migrants from the Watson Hotel to the Brooklyn Cruise Terminal in Red Hook. This weekend, the city began moving single men to the 1,000-bed facility in Brooklyn. The move met with controversy Sunday night. Members of the NYPD standing by as tension flared. Migrants refusing to board the bus to Brooklyn, saying they are tired of the constant moving and chanting they want a permanent home. In a statement, the mayor's office says the facilities at Brooklyn Cruise Terminal will provide the same services as every other humanitarian relief center in the city, and the scheduled relocations to Brooklyn Cruise Terminal this weekend took place as planned. We remain in serious need of support from both our state and federal governments. This comes as the city has received more than 42,000 asylum seekers since last spring.
They have the audacity to be over here protesting and demanding that Eric Adams accommodate them. I mean, this is absolutely clown world. I don't know who, what American in their right mind think that any of this is okay. This ain't okay in no sense of the word. Where do anyone get off on thinking you can go to another country, walk in there illegally, and demand that they take care of you on the taxpayer dime, on your dime? While Americans and homeless vets and the mentally ill are all out on the streets. But yet, Trump was bad for saying he want America first. All the patriots that supported MAGA for America First, they're racists, right? See, you sambos and mammies are just stupid. Y'all just dumb. Because winter is coming, especially to you single black mothers. I see what's going on out here. You got your voucher. but ain't nobody accepting those vouchers. You know, the Section 8s y'all sitting on. You're not finding housing, and a lot of y'all are becoming homeless. But these illegals are not homeless. They're given a place to stay. They're demanding a place to stay, and they're going to get it on the American taxpayer dime. Let me read some of these comments before I close this out over here on TikTok. Because, you know, I swear, the reason why I'm directing this at these shines because the fact that they thought that bringing more brown people is going to make it better for them. All skin folk ain't kin folks. And these immigrants that's coming over here, they don't give a damn about you, your slavery, your hangups, your racial, all that. They don't care nothing about that. They coming over here for themselves to get what they want to get. This woman said at 55K per person, I don't think so. That's how much it costs per migrant. I don't even, she said, if I don't pay my rent, I'm on the street and there's no help for me because I'm a single woman with no children. And again, no one seems to care about the American citizens that are homeless right now. Is she in denial both about women and children when there are continuous influx? There is no room. Where should they go? A place is provided. It's ended. What about the American citizens who live on the street because they can't afford it? Mothers and children. See, this is in response to this woman right here, this activist that's out here advocating for doing a standoff.
How are we getting in this? What's your name?
My name's Yvette Salarka. I'm with the Coalition to Defend Affirmative Action, Integration, and Immigrant Rights and Fight for Equality by Any Means Necessary. So I think the way that this should end is that the migrants who are out here should be allowed back into the hotel. That has been their home now for how many weeks or months?
So?
New York City. No one can claim that there isn't space or resources to be able to make sure that the people who are the backbone of this city, most who are immigrants, don't and shouldn't have the right to humane conditions.
Oh, so immigrants, illegal immigrants. See, I'm tired of saying immigrants because these are not immigrants. Immigrants are people who immigrate here legally, and they're here on a type of legal immigration status. That's what an immigrant is. You know, these are illegals. These are the undocumented, or some new name they put up. Then they call them migrants. They're not supposed to be here, and it's not our responsibility to take care of them either.
It's warm, that's safe, where they're not packed in like sardines in a warehouse. They were already living here. This is their home. They should be able to stay.
They say they're repurposing the hotel so they can take care of women and children and families.
And they should take care of women and children and families. And wherever the women and children and families are already, they should be able to stay there or get improved conditions. But you don't rob Peter to pay Paul. You don't just move migrants around and put people into a warehouse by the water where it's freezing, where it's a complete COVID super spreader event.
Well, why don't you take them in your house?
Or diseases, 1,000 people, head to toe beds, packed in with only 4 bathrooms. No, that's nothing but detention. That's a prison. In New York City, there are people in this city who spend more on a handbag than many people see in a whole year. So no, there is resources in the city. Wherever the mayor has to find it, he can find it, and he's already got it.
That's the coalition fighting for these illegals, these migrants. Well, I don't care what you call them. Where are the coalitions that are out here fighting for Americans? Where are those coalitions? Where are those coalitions that are fighting for people that are being priced out of their homes and can't find another place to stay because they can't afford it? Where are the coalitions for those Americans? Americans who were born here. This is their birthright. This is their country. This is why America First will always be the largest party in America. This is why you can't beat MAGA, you bagel motherfuckers that own the Jew, that own the fucking media. You're not going to beat us. We're not going anywhere. America first. Americans first. Put your comments below. Share this video. Subscribe to my channel. I'm so pissed. I can't even fathom that anyone can even have any ounce of sympathy for these people. I say, put them on a bus or a plane or whatever. I say, no, a bus, not a plane. Bus them, ride them all back over the border and dump them in Mexico. I don't care where they go, but they got to get out of here. Put your comments below. Share my video. Subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. I'll see you tonight at 8 p.m. for Tacky Tuesdays. Good night, everyone. Have a good day and be blessed, everyone.